Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom. Facebook Live, we have arrived. One more time, y'all. Let's get it in.
Conference muted. Conference recording started.
I want to thank everybody for chiming in. This is Watchman Derek Yehuda, Israel, also known as Pastor Derek, on this Shabbat, on this 17th day in February 2024. We back at it like a fanatic, y'all. Hallelujah. We in Romans, the 5th chapter. Hallelujah. Thank the Most High for everyone that's in attendance. Give y'all praise because he's worthy. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Son, good to see you in here. Mother Katie, good to see you in here as well. Al Mal, good to see you in here. And again, everyone in attendance, thank the Most High for you. With no further ado,
somebody in the bathroom.
Okay. Let's get ready to get it in. Let's get ready to get it. Let's go to Romans, the 5th chapter, y'all. We're in Romans, the 5th chapter. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Romans 5. Anyone need a Bible? Y'all need a Bible?
Shoes go.
Romans 5, there's a Bible.
Yeah, it's the New Testament, so you got it.
Romans 5 and 1. Look what this say, y'all. Stay with me if we can stop chatting during service. That'd be cool. Huh? Romans 5. Romans 5, y'all. This is so crooked. I'm going to have to leave it like this. Romans 5, y'all. And 1. Look what this says. This says, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with Yah through our Adonai Yahushua Mashiach. Right? Now, the therefore comes from the previous things we already learned, right? And it was talking about what Abraham, our father, had learned. And what Abraham had learned was having a relationship with Yah is spiritual and is governed and maintained by faith, right? We need to know that, and I mean that, especially dealing with the prophetic value of the Bible, you know, the history book. Not only is it, you know, history, and from this standpoint, I mean his story, Yah's story, not the devil's story, you know, the victor, the colonizer's story. No, they're liars. That his history is his story. He's a liar. But from the biblical standpoint, Yeshua, Yehuda, and I might be able to touch on that question you had too, the statement you have, but if it fits in the lesson, then I believe it will. But anyway, having a relationship with the Most High, what Abraham, you know, has found is trusting the Most High at his word is your very salvation. trusting the Most High at His work. It's not just trusting Him for the fishes and loaves, though. See, people like to trust the Most High for the fishes and loaves, meaning how they can benefit from Him from a carnal standpoint. No, trusting the Most High at His word, Pastor Nathan Jones, I'm glad you're in here with us. But trusting the Most High at His word entails His moral character, His spiritual character, which is all encompassed in His word. Right? And so, therefore, Romans 5 and 1, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with Yah, Don Deans, right? We have a peace with Yah through something, right? Through something. Uh-huh. Through what? Through our Master Adonai, right? Yahushua HaMashiach. Now here we go again. Understanding when we're dealing with Yahushua HaMashiach, what you want to talk about concerning Yahushua. Let's talk about it. You want to talk about the fact that he's Adonai, aka Master, right? Which is a description of him, right? Being master, right? Or you want to talk about the fact that he's Yahushua. That's a name, y'all. Yah is salvation. Gene, Barbara, Logan, stay with me, right? See, he's Adonai, he's master. He's Yahushua, which means Yah's salvation. That's his name, right? And he's the Mashiach. They call him Christ. He's the Messiah. Jasmine. Are y'all with me? You mean the Yahoo? Listen. Romans 5 and 1. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with Yah through Yahushua. Right? I told you what Yahushua is, period, and what he is to us is Master. I told you what his name means. Yah is salvation, meaning the Messiah is Yah to come rescue us. This is the method that the Most High used to rescue us, to save us, right? Which deems him to be the Messiah. Let's go further about him, though. When we go back to John 1 and 1, it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with Yah, and the Word was Yah. So the Word was with the Most High, but the Word was the Most High. What was with him? The Word. What was him? The Word. What is Yah? His Word. He could talk.
Right.
That's not another deity. He could talk. Listen. He could talk, Teresa. Therefore, being justified by faith, what justifies us is faith in the Most High. What gave us peace, listen to me, what gave us peace with Yah is we got it through the Messiah, which is the Word made flesh. We got peace, Reed. We got peace with the Most High through the Word. In the beginning was the Word, John 1 and 1. In the beginning was the Word was with Yah, the Word was Yah. Go down to the 14th verse, and the Word was made flesh. The Word, which is Yah, was made flesh. What's the flesh? The Son. the body that the Word lived in, the human being that the Word lived in. The flesh is the human being. Your mama made the human being you are. You a daughter or a son? I don't want to hear nothing about your pronouns. Just take that back to the devil. Keep that out of here. That's just these wicked folks on what's your pronoun. You jokers, you. Talk back to me. When the Word was born, it was a male. His flesh was a male, the son. He either would have been a girl or a boy. If it was a girl, it would have been the daughter of Yah. But since it was a male, it was the son of Yah. John 1:14 said, and the Word was made flesh. The flesh was a male, the son of Yah. So when we deal with the Messiah, we're dealing with the Word of Yah in human form, being found fashioned as a man. Philippians 2 says, being found fashioned as a man. The Word was found fashioned as a man. Why? Because he came to save man. He became the object of the rescue. Yeah. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace. So we back in peace with Yah through the Word of Yah, which is our Adonai and it's our Messiah. Are y'all with me? You want to be saved? You want to be reconciled back with the Word of Yah? Is that making sense to y'all? I'm going to keep teaching. Second verse then teaches us. By whom, talking about the Messiah, the Word made flesh. By whom also we have access by faith. By whom? That's the Messiah. Also, we have access by faith into the grace, the unmerited favor. We got a relationship with him that's so cool. It's unearnable. And it abides forever. And it supplies us with everything we need for salvation. His unmerited favor. He look at us like, I love you and I'm going to rescue from everything because you trust me. Oh, I'm trying to tell you something. When you start looking at scriptures like no weapon formed against me shall prosper, there's nothing on earth that's going to work against. People can have people. I be around people that even have their opinion to me. It's laughable to me. They watch the Most High keep blessing me though. They watch. Look at this. Let me tell you something. When you belong to Yah, you abide in his unmerited favor. I'm telling you that. If you obey him. If you have trust, if you trust him at his word, I'm not talking about the type of person that trusts him for fishes and loaves. Trust him to heal their body only. Trust him to give them money only. Trust him when they in a bad situation. They're trusting him to get them out. But they don't live for him. They don't put him first. They say they put him first, but they don't understand. To put Yah first is to put what he say first. And if you put what he say first, you stay away from all appearance of evil. You don't support nothing that comes from the devil. You won't have nothing to do with it. You're going to roll with his word. I'm trying to tell you something. You're not committing fornication because his word told you not to. You side with his word. Having faith in his word will stop you from being a fornicator. Having faith in his word will stop you from committing adultery. Having faith in his word will stop you from holding grudges. Having faith in his word will cause you to walk in love and be about your father's business. I'm trying to tell you something. Listen. So when the second verse says, by whom, it's talking about by the Messiah, which is the word of Yah. And let me tell you something else about the Messiah. He's the perfect balance of Yah. What I mean by that, meaning he's both 100% Yah, the word, but he's also 100% man. 100%. He didn't cheat the system. He was really born a human being, found fashion as a man. But the balance is when the rich young ruler came to him and called him good, he checked him. He didn't completely check him because he was good. He checked him in a way to say, why did you call me good? And then he made it plain. There's none good but Yah. John 10 says he was the good shepherd. So he was good. But he wanted to know, why are you calling me good? Are you ready to serve a man? Are you ready to worship a man? You calling me good? What you think about me? No, I'm not here to reconcile you back with a man, a good man. I'm here to reconcile you back with your creator. We need the creator. We don't need a good man. We need the creator. And curse is the man that trusts in man and make flesh his strength. No, we ain't looking for strength from a human being. We all need to be reconciled back with our creator, period. Are y'all with me? Back to him being the perfect balance. The perfect balance is, though he was a man and a good man, he stayed humble. Are you with me? And he gave all credit back to Yah at all times. Are y'all with me still? Listen.
Hallelujah.
So by whom, the perfect example, the Messiah, also we have access. What gave us access? The Messiah. By faith, though. What activates the Messiah in your life is having faith in him. Stay with me. Having faith in his word. By whom also we have access by faith into this grace. Then you end up in unmerited favor. No, nothing on earth can stop me now. Oh, it's threats, big threats running around here. I used to be stressed out about the threats. Boy, I couldn't sleep at night. They finna do what? They finna do what, for real? Oh, he'll build your faith. He'll get you ready. He'll send you through boot camp. He'll send you through boot camp. Circumstances in your life is building your faith that you trust him no matter what happens. See, I can trust Yah for me. I can trust Yah for my wife. I can trust Yah for my family, my children. Really? Everyone has to do that for themselves. I'm telling you that. You got to be able to trust Yah for yourself and your family. Yeah. And then we got to teach them, Yah, our young folk. We got to teach them him, and they got to be able to see it. Talk back to me. Listen. Second verse. By whom also we have access, by faith, into this grace wherein we stand, and we stand, and we're not falling, y'all. And rejoice in hope of the glory of Yah. And we're rejoicing. Hope is not like this dyslexic, wicked English language. It's deeper than that. This hope is hopeful. This hope is solid, right? This hope is like a, it's more of a guarantee. It's a spiritual trust hope, type of a hope. It's not like I hope he do. No. It's not that type of hope. No, this is more of a I'm assured he gonna do it type of a hope. I'm just telling you because of this wicked language. Stay with me, Banks. For killer, you with me? So by whom also have access by faith into this grace when we stand and we rejoice in the hope of the glory of Yah, right? He's magnified. He's happy. He's satisfied. He can beat his chest by his children. That's his glory. We're his glory. Oh, y'all, come on now. Listen. So the third verse, look what it say. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations. We triumph. We're steadfast. We're complete. We're like glory. We're like at our best. I'm trying to teach Destiny. Listen, we're fulfilled. I'll use that. we're fulfilled. We triumph in tribulation also. When things happen to his children, like everything turns into a test, it turns into an opportunity. The test is not just like a test, like you're taking a quiz, but the type of test it is, it's an improving type of a circumstance. It improves us. It makes us better. We become better. Like even the things that should make us bitter, because of him, you become better. You learn from it and you grow. The things that will equate to fire, right? Something hot, difficult, right? Transforms us. It's a purifier. It purifies us. Being left out purifies you. Being diagnosed with an illness purifies you. Being disrespected purifies you. Being lonely purifies you. You learn to wait on your source, not the resource. You learn to wait and depend on your source. That's why in James, when he was talking to the 12 tribes that are scattered, he knew the hell they was going to be going through on earth. And he told them in the second verse, James 1 and 2, he said, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations. Diverse temptations is uncomfortable circumstances. Cause discomfort. But he said, count it all joy when you're uncomfortable. When you're going through things that are not, that you don't like. He said, count that joy. Count all joy when you fall into diverse temptations. Knowing this, you got to know something. You got to know what's going on. Knowing this, you got to know what's going on. That the trying of your faith, what's happening? That the trying of your faith is working patience. You're learning to wait on Yah. Through trouble. Through a tore-up family. Through people that despise you for no reason. Through people that take kindness for weakness. When you feel like the stepchild and nobody care about you. If you know Yah, you know that it's working for your good. It's transforming you into his image. You end up tight with the Most High when you're a believer. See, when you're not a believer, you feel suicidal. When you're not a believer, you get depressed. You're going to need some medicine and stuff. When you're not a believer, you on your own. And the trials of this life will bury you. Talk back to me. Yes, it only works when you're obedient, son. We talking faith. See, listen, faith in him, faith without works is dead. And true faith comes with works, and works is obedience. Are y'all with me? You got to obey. The trust that we have in Yah is we obey him. And then no matter what happens on earth, nothing will pluck you out of his hands, and it'll do nothing but make you better. You'll grow. You'll see your own growth. Other people around you will definitely see your growth, and they'll benefit from it too. Are y'all with me? Make sure y'all with me. Clap in here. Y'all put a one in here, y'all. Are y'all with me? Can I get some? Yeah, I don't want y'all to fall asleep. The Ruah is working too well today.
I know.
Listen. So the second verse says, by whom also, listen, I like that emoji, Reed. Listen, by whom also we have access by faith, son. You saw that? That means you're obeying his word. Into the unmerited faith. Now, there's nothing that can pluck you out of his hands. You're living by unmerited favor. You didn't earn it. You didn't deserve it. But you trust him. And he going to deliver you. He going to present you blameless before his presence. I'm telling you. You're going to have eternal life. Your life is not in vain. It's going to work out for you. Listen to me. By whom also we have access by faith into the grace wherein we stand. And we stand in too. Things should have knocked you down. You ain't going to hit the ground. Things that should have knocked you down, you ain't gonna hit the ground. We stand, right? And not only are we standing, but we rejoice in hope of the glory of Yah. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience. See what I mean? We're learning to wait on Yah, because he's going to work it out. So the fourth verse discloses to us, and patience worketh experience. When you wait on Yah, you're going to find out he's good for it, Sabrina. Witherspoon, listen to me. You're going to find out he's good for it. I'm saying you're obeying him. You're not cussing. You're not an alcoholic. You're not committing adultery. We in here, Tubbs. You're obeying him. Ah, you're a living example for sure. Stay with me. Uh-huh. Listen. So 5 and 3. Romans 5 and 3. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations. It's ugly. It's finna get real ugly. You think it's ugly now, it's about to get uglier. We ain't tripping. Listen. Knowing that tribulation worketh patience. You gotta know what's going on. You gotta know that tribulation causes you to get closer to Yah. And the purpose of this life, listen, for the believer is to be reconciled with Yah and get closer to him. We know this life is like temporary, and he gave us like some clues, like a caterpillar with its little ugly self. Oh, isn't he ugly? Isn't he ugly?
Yes.
Oh, he need a wig, you dig? He ugly. And he ain't even, his traveling mechanism is real limited. He's scooting on little puffy pillow things. I don't know what it is. I don't know if them little rolling shoes or whatever the heck. He's ugly. And he can barely travel. He can't even run from you. He can see you finna do something to him. He can't even run. Listen. And listen to me. So he ended up dying. He made a casket for himself. What they call it, a cocoon?
Cocoon.
He cocooned himself, right? And he's dead in there. He can't breathe in there, nothing. He's dead. And then all of a sudden he comes out. Listen, y'all talking to us. Then he comes out beautiful. He went from being on the ground, couldn't even travel, to flying through the air. Talk back to me. Come on, Frank. Talk back to me. Listen. You got to understand that patience worketh experience. Listen. And experience worketh hope. I told you the hope this is talking about is a confidence. It's not an iffy hope. It's a confidence that y'all got it. See, the circumstances in this life will prepare you for a wilderness experience. And that's the truth. What should have happened with the children of Israel, it did with Joshua and Caleb. But what should have happened with the children of Israel is after he conquered the most powerful country in the world, the richest country in the world, he conquered them in the presence of Israel with 10 plagues. That should have built confidence in them for Yah. But they were so twisted, it didn't. And they turned on him, and he ended up killing them too. Ungrateful jokers. That's how he felt about it. He said, I swear my wrath, I'm killing every last one of them. But he let Joshua and Caleb make it in. He did not make allow the ministry of his word on stone make it in either. Moshe. He let Moshe see it. Because you can't see the promised land walking in the spirit. You can't see a true relationship with Yah through the Ten Commandments. You really can. You can't perform it, but you can see it. You got to reapproach this thing from a spiritual standpoint. Are y'all with me? Mm-hmm. Going into Canaan, the promised land, is a shadow and type of walking in the spirit. Namesake, Yahusha, they call him Joshua. Yehoshua, they called him Joshua. It's actually the name of the Messiah. His namesake is the one that took the children of Israel into the promised land, Canaan. Moses represents the law. He could see it, but he couldn't do it. Because Romans 3:3 said, for what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh. It ain't the law's fault. Weak through the flesh, Yah sending his son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. Where's sin at? In the flesh. Where's sin at? It's in our evil human nature. For sin, condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. That the righteousness of the law. What's the righteousness of the law? His word. Yah's word was on the stones of law. The righteousness of the law is his word. Get rid of the stone. Then his word is spirit that we hide in our hearts that we might not sin against it. We were baptized with the Ruach HaKodesh, filled with the spirit of his word that will lead and guide us into all truth. I'm trying to tell y'all something. That's a good place to put a 7 in here or hallelujah or something.
Hallelujah.
Listen, y'all. So we understand now, back to 3, so I'm going to walk the devil down this evening. Uh-huh. Come on, y'all, listen. Not only so, but we glory in tribulations. Things ain't going well. Look at here, because it ain't well. We walking through the valley of the shadow of death, but we ain't scared. We fear no evil. Why? Because his rod and his staff, they comfort us. Yah's with us. Listen. Third verse. We glory, we triumph, we're excited, listen to me, we're excited in tribulations. We're counting all joy when we fall into diverse temptations, knowing that the triangle of our faith is working patience, and that patience have a perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, lacking nothing. We ready for anything the devil throw. Y'all gonna knock it out the park because we walking in this unmerited favor, what they call grace. Listen, third verse. So we glory in tribulations, knowing, though, you got to know what's going on, that tribulation is working patience. We're waiting on Yah. And patience, experience. Because every time you wait on Yah, you're going to end up with another positive experience in your relationship with him. Because he's going to come through. What it do? What it do? He make it do what it do. Listen. And experience hope, meaning I know he gonna do it again. he got me out of this. I ain't worried about the next. He got me out of this. I ain't worried about the next. I trust. Look, my faith is being built right in y'all face. I don't know about y'all, but my faith is like, it's like skyrocketing nowadays. I'm feeling good about the most threats from these devils. Agenda 2030. These rascals is messing with the air. They messing with the water. They messing with the land. They messing in the spirit. This devil, they acting a fool. Oh, and I'm getting more and more excited. Oh, the book of Revelations, the seals is being unloosed. Bold judgments is poured out, and I'm over here just having the time in him. I ain't cussing, y'all. I ain't fornicating, y'all. I ain't committing adultery either, and I ain't drunk nor high. Come on, talk back to me. Oh, I want to preach and teach. I want to live the thing. Are y'all with me?
Yeah,
stay with me. Listen. So the third verse let us know that we glory in tribulations, and tribulations going to work patience. We waiting on him. And we waiting on him is building experience. And that experience, I got confidence. I got hope in him. He going to do it again. Listen. So when we get to the fifth verse, look what it say. It say, hope maketh not ashamed. Having confidence in the Most High, you'll never be ashamed. Listen to what he's saying. Turn your phone off, son. Listen and come back and sit down. Listen, and hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of Yah is shed in our hearts by the Ruach HaKodesh, which is given on us. Are y'all with me? Mm-hmm. So Hope, he's going to never let you down. He's never going to let you down, right? Because the love of Yah is shared abroad in our hearts. His love, we're submerged in his love. We're submerged in his unmerited favor, what they call grace. We have favor. We're justified. We're pilgrims passing through. There's nothing on earth that's going to cause us, I said those that have faith in him. I said those that trust him. There's nothing on earth is going to cause them to turn their back on him. I didn't say they didn't make mistakes. I'm saying they're not going to turn on him. The woman is not going to be able to pull him away from. The woman is not going to be able to pull her away from. The man is not going to be able to pull her. The man is not going to be able to pull the man. Men are like men. Come on, talk back to me. Yeah. Y'all can pull you from that. From that. Talk back to me.
Yes, he can.
Yeah, if you got faith in it. Oh, I'm going to teach anyway. Listen. Fifth verse says, and hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of Yah is shed abroad in our hearts by the Ruach HaKodesh. He baptized himself inside of us. He stood at the door and knocked. Any man heard, opened up, let him in. The Ruach HaKodesh came and filled us. Uh-huh. And he said, after the Ruach HaKodesh has come upon you, you shall receive power. Listen. The power that we receive is the ability to do what he called us to do. But not only do what he called us to do, we're filled with his love. Oh, my goodness. That's why no weapon formed against you won't prosper. We can't take the credit for it. This is a faith race. We don't need religion, y'all. We don't need commandments on stone. We need to hide the word in our hearts that we might not sin against. I'm trying to tell you the secret, y'all. I understand that Israel woke up and we found out we've been lied to. Bamboozled, hoodwinked. I understand that. They stole our identity. I understand that. They made us feel like we was thugs and nothing. Bunch of losers and gangsters. Pimples and pimping and pandering and panhandling. That's how they market us. That's why they stick us with needles when we're born. They got chemicals that they give the babies inside the hospital, and the average brother, the little boy, is coming out with autism. We got so many autistic children coming out because they sticking them in the hospitals. Yeah, that's what they're doing. And these girls need to know that. You got to have Big Mama open your doggone mouth, Big Mama. Mm-hmm. Unless Big Mama drunk too with a mini skirt on.
Ooh, yes.
Paw, somebody need to tell these little girls, don't you let them stick your child with them needles, including the vitamin B. They're devils and they're liars. Wake up, Israel. Talk back to me. Y'all is here to rescue his children. Come on, y'all. But the things that we faced because we turned on him. We got scattered and we got shipped into slavery. We're in the valley of the shadow of death, and we're definitely in the land of our captivity. Mm. We've been colonized. We've been woolly lynched.
We've been traumatized.
Talk back to me.
Yes, we have.
And our only way out, if my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and seek my face. And you got some turning to turn from their wicked way. Turn away from this Catholicism. Turn away from this religiousism. Talk back to me and turn to his word. Trust the Creator. Believe him. Oh, I'm trying to teach y'all something. Listen.
Yes.
Our hope make him not ashamed. Mm-hmm. 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 Our hope make him not trusting, having confidence. Hope is confidence, y'all. Confidence make him not ashamed. Bible said, cast not away therefore your confidence. It has great recompense of reward. That's what hope. It's not the hopeless. It's not that iffy hope. This is, I know he got it. I know he got me. I know he, I don't care nothing about their AI. I know y'all got me. I don't care nothing about their drones. I don't care nothing about boots on the ground. When martial law, I don't care what they, I don't care about their tracking systems. The fake eye is at the top of the pyramid on the back of their money. I don't care nothing about their eye. I care about Yah, my creator, the creator of all. Got all power in his head. If Yah be for you, he's more than the whole world. The whole world against you.
Hallelujah.
Snap out of it, Israel. Snap out of it. Somebody type in here, snap out of it. Come on, I need some help, y'all. Type in here, snap out of it. Snap out of it. Come on. Snap out of it. Come on, y'all. Fear first. Look what they say. I just need one or two people to snap out of it. Type that. And hope maketh not ashamed. Look at it. Look at here. And hope maketh not ashamed because the love of Yah is shared abroad in our hearts. How? By the Ruach HaKodesh. Whoa! Oh, it's his spirit. Can you hear it? Come on, y'all. He baptizes himself inside. He's so attached to us. It's personal now. Uh-huh. He baptized himself inside of us. And you know what he's going to do? Because he's in us, he's going to deliver. I don't care what you was. You were ex or something. Whatever you was, he baptized himself inside of you. And he's going to transform. Listen. He gonna change you. He gonna change. He gonna transform you by the renewing of your mind. And you know what he gonna? He gonna present you blameless. Listen to what I'm trying to teach you. Hallelujah. He's gonna present as filthy as we was, all the crap we done. Listen, even the mistakes we made when we was with him. He know how to clean that up too. If you're pure in your intentions, if you're pure in your heart, he gonna forgive you. We don't cover our sins. Proverbs 28-13. We don't cover our sins because if you cover your sins, you won't prosper. But he didn't confess. I'm wrong. I was wrong. He didn't confess and forsake. I don't want to do it no more. Shall have mercy. I'm trying to tell you something. Uh huh. Listen. He's gonna present us blameless. And there's nothing the devil can do. I keep telling y'all about Monroe. I probably need to repost it. I'm telling you again. There was a pastor by the name of Monroe. His wife and his staff, they fell out the sky, right? And they died, right? But he was like a real Christian, Catholic type of a preacher, as far as I'm concerned, with the level of word I know. I understood that he just was with their doctrine and he was on that. So I couldn't understand why his plane fell. I just couldn't understand. Until someone posted on my page, he said how they gave us Jesus. And he preached exactly who these people was. Are. He preached who they was and he preached the lies they told. And he was naming them and he was preaching his butt off. After that, his plane fell out the sky. That means that they couldn't buy him. That means he wasn't for sale. Even though he was very successful, he was touching money, but he never got caught up in this world, though. He was caught up in the Most High. And when, even though the things I used to teach and the things that he used to teach, you know how you go from glory to glory? You continue, when you're sincere, you continue to learn. There was things that I used to teach. I don't teach no more because I learned more. You go from glory to glory. You keep growing in him. He kept growing. And when you continue to grow and touch as many people as he was touching, the devil's mad. You come a threat. So he want to shut your mouth. Listen. Obviously, they didn't have nothing for him. Obviously, he wasn't scared of him. Obviously, he wouldn't stop. So they stopped him. No, they just gave him his ticket into eternity to be with the Most High. Oh, they messed up. They messed up when they touched the Messiah. The Bible in Corinthians, 1st chapter said, had they known, they never would have did it. Had they known he was the Adonai of Kabah, what they call the Lord of glory, they never would have crucified him. So when you have a brother like T.D. Jakes that teaches Constantine in the same sentence as the apostles now, there's a couple explosions that they had, a couple of death threats on him. Then all of a sudden I heard him denounce his one Elohim. He switched. Then he started hanging around with Oprah and Tyler Perry. I'm telling you what it is. It's not like he don't know truth. He wasn't willing to die for it. He was touching too much money. He was having too much fun. He went from a storefront to 8,000, 9,000 members. He became the pastor of the whole nation. He was touching too much, and he wasn't willing to let it go. And he sold out. And I feel for it. And I'm praying for him. I'm not here to condemn him. That's between him and Yah. He's still my brother, but I'm praying for him. He need to be willing to die. He got to let it go. Let it go. Come on, talk back to me.
Yes, he do.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You can't get caught up in this place like that. Sellout preachers. There ain't no elbow room for no sellout preacher. Tell the truth. Preach the truth. Men should be with men. Say it. Women shouldn't be with women. No, not in a relationship. Something wrong with you. And you're going to go to hell, too. You're going to be destroyed. You don't want to be destroyed with this wicked place because they marketed it and seduced you and lied to you. We all get tempted. Everybody get tempted. When you're young and impressionable, you think it's natural, it's normal, and this is what it is. No, you get tempted to kill people. Everyone that got tempted to kill people don't kill people. Only somebody is weak and got overcame. Then you actually do it. Talk back to me. All kind of thoughts come to everybody. But those that belong to Yah got enough sense. That ain't right. When you got people that love you older than you. That ain't right. See, they try to make it a law that if your child coming up, a girl attracted to a girl or a boy attracted to a boy, they want to make it a law that you can't stop them. You can't tell them what Yah said. You can't tell them the truth. You can't correct them. Devil, get the heck up out of here. Ain't nobody scared of you. Devil, you'll be in hell burning soon. You'll be in a lake of fire for eternity. Those of us that belong to Yah, we're going to do what Yah said. Talk back to me. We put a two in here if I'm telling the truth. We obey Yah. Scared of these guys. Call that love. That ain't love. That's perversion. You're a pervert. Come on, talk back to me.
Hallelujah.
Scared of no devil. It's one Elohim while I'm talking. And I'm going to use his real name if that's all right with you. If it ain't, that's cool too. I'm going to do it anyway. How about that?
Hallelujah.
Let me get ready to get out of here, y'all. We ain't scared. We the opposite. Talk back to me. And so, look at this. I'm getting ready to go. The sixth verse then teaches us, for when we were yet without strength, did y'all hear that? Let me read this. For when we were yet without strength, in due time, the Mashiach died. For the ungodly. Did he die for the righteous? No, it said he died for the ungodly. Is y'all with me?
Yes.
He died for the ungodly.
Ungodly.
The scripture said when we were scared, it's tore up from the flow up. He died for us. Are y'all with me? Uh-huh. When we was unlovable, when our mama didn't like us. He died for us. When Paul didn't like you, so I'm telling you, when Grandma didn't like you, get off my porch, Theotis. Go on, Theo, don't come around here. I'm going to call your parole officer. He died for us. Mm-mm. I don't like the way you look at the girls. Mm-mm. Get off my porch. Listen. For when we were yet without strength in due time, listen. When we were out strength, right? That's so deep in folds. Because when we were helpless, even captives, when we were slaves, when we were powerless even on earth, and say we're powerless to our flesh, we lie all the doggone time. We just liars. We slick. We lie. We freaky, horny. We slick. You know, we want to hurt ourselves because we just freaky and we just out of pocket. Are y'all listening to me?
Hallelujah.
When we were out strength, meaning Romans the 7th chapter, listen what Paul said. Paul said, the things that I want to do, which was to obey Yah, I couldn't do. Right? And the things that I hated to do, which was go against Yah, I found myself doing. He was told what? He was without strength. You said you want to do good, right? You want to do good. Listen to me.
Hallelujah.
You want to do good, right? You want to do good, right?
Hallelujah.
And then you don't do it. You ever said, you know what? I'm going to go over and apologize and make peace. Next thing you know, the police is flying over there. You out there, wig off, pumps, and hair slicked back. You got razor blades and your little Covadas. And you got Vaseline. You out there chucking them. I thought you were over there to make peace. I thought I was over it. As soon as I saw, I took off on her.
Wow.
Without strength. Want to do the will of Yah, then you end up posting something crazy. Want to come out, but then, you know, they call you and sweeten the deal. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You a gangster rapper saying all this stuff that Yah don't, you're going to end up dying for it. Yah don't want you saying, and you say, I quit, and then they gave you enough. They raised the pot, raised the stakes. now you can't walk away. Now you ain't gonna walk away. Talk back to me. We don't make goofy music. We don't make goofy movies. we don't do nothing that glorifies the devil. We've been called out of the darkness into the marvelous light. I'ma teach y'all.
Hallelujah.
Hey, you with me, Tubbs? You already know you're a part of the family anyway, Tubbs. Listen, I'm getting ready to go, y'all. But look what it say. 6th verse says, and when we were yet without strength, oh, we was hopeless, helpless. Listen, in due time, it's appointed time for everything, y'all. That's why you got to have patience. We not running it like that. We just happy to be in the car. Are y'all listening? We just happy to be on board. We just happy to have our names written in the Lamb's Book of Life.
Hallelujah.
We just happy that whatever trouble, big trouble, too, the world is in, he paid the ransom for us and he called us out. And we happy to be translated into the kingdom of his dear son. Y'all should clap for that because that's kind of like good news. Can y'all put a hallelujah in there? I'm just happy to be in the... Oh, y'all.
Hallelujah.
Tell you what.
We just happy.
Tell you what. I don't know what they play. Yeah, I kind of do know what they plan on doing. It don't mean nothing to me.
Hallelujah.
Nothing they talking about is going to pull me from y'all. How about that? Listen. I'm finna go, y'all. Listen. Listen. It said, For when we were yet without strength in due time, the Messiah died for the ungodly, not for the righteous, for the ungodly.
Hallelujah.
To give us opportunity to change. Mm-hmm. Isn't that good?
That's a good life.
I wouldn't be who I am today if it wasn't for him. He did this to me.
Hallelujah.
Oh boy, was I a rascal. Oh, he did this to me.
Hallelujah.
That's a blessing.
He can change you.
Yes, it is.
Oh, this is good news. No wonder they call it good news. Is it good news, y'all?
Good news.
Very good.
Put a 3 in here if it's good news. Put a 3. Y'all clap if you want to. That's up to you. But put a 3 in here if it's good news.
Good news. Good news.
Oh, this is good news, y'all.
It Yes, it is.
Glory, glory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm finna go, y'all. Listen. Look what it said. For scarcely for a righteous man will one die. You got some groovy people running around here. Folks ain't finna give up their life for them. Happy to know you, but when it's your time to go, you gotta go. Gotta go. I ain't going for you. Listen. Scarcely for a righteous man will one die. Yet preadventure for a good man, some would even dare to die. Listen. But Yah commended his love towards us, in that while we were yet sinners. When you get this revelation, you kind of start cutting people some slack. Did y'all hear what I said?
Mm-hmm.
You start cutting people some slack when you get this revelation. Now, I'm not trying to reroute anyone that's been doing that year after year, year in, year out, for folk that reject them and hurt them. I'm not trying to set nobody up to go and get hurt some more. Because scripture do teach some people you got to get away from. But you better have a track record of you still loving on them and trying. You can't be have a short fuse when it come to other people and want y'all to have a long fuse when it come to you. Talk back to me. You quick to cut folks. Oh, I'll cut you off. Well, y'all cut you off. He said, if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your heavenly Father forgive you yours. Put that in your pipe and smoke. Get the weed out your pipe. Put that in your pipe and smoke.
Tell me about it.
Get your cannabis card. Yeah. Smoke that. Listen to me. When you get this revelation, I'm finna go. Real talk. I'm finna go, y'all. Afer says, but Yah commended his love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, scandalous. The Messiah died for us. Yes. Are y'all with me?
Yes, he did.
We was wrong. Some of us still wrong. We need to get it right, y'all. How many of y'all willing to get it right? How many of y'all willing to bow down to him for real, walk away from all sin and have faith in him, put a foe in there?
Hallelujah.
Oh, y'all can clap up in here. Y'all live. It's live for y'all.
Yes,
ain't no foes floating around here.
Hallelujah.
How many of y'all willing? How many of y'all put a foe in there? How many of y'all willing to denounce all sin? If you're fornicating, you're willing to walk away. Get out the bed and walk away. How many of y'all willing to do that? You commit adultery. Your spouse did you wrong. Now you're adultery hearted. How many of y'all willing to give it up for Yah? Come on, put a foe in here. How many of y'all are alcoholic or drunk, but you willing to put the bottle down? Come on, talk back to me. How many of y'all got a cannabis card and you ain't nothing but a dope head? Come on, put a foe in here. He's ready to set you free. He will set you free. How many of y'all hold grudges? Short fuse when it comes to other folks, but you want y'all to have a long fuse for you. Put your foe up in here.
Yes.
It's deliverance here. He love us.
Yes.
He love us. He just waiting for us to reciprocate. He's standing at the door knocking. If any man hear the word, open up, let him in. He coming in. What was on the stone? What was on the Ten Commandments? He'll baptize it to you right now. Open up your heart. He'll fill you up with his Ruach HaKodesh from head to toe right now. Come on, yes. come on.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yeah. He'll set the captive free. Anybody want to be free?
Hallelujah.
Anybody want to be free from yourself?
Hallelujah.
Anybody want a clean slate? Give one. Anybody want a clean slate?
Yes.
He'll give you one. Give one. Come on. Clean your heart.
Clean
your heart. You need some help? Put five on it. Let's pray. You need some help? Put five on it.
Yes.
You need some help, Rhonda? Put five on it. Let's pray.
Hallelujah.
It's time for the five to arrive.
Yes.
Put five on it. We getting ready to pray. I said I was going to let y'all go. Hallelujah. Y'all ain't gonna let you go. May you rest rule and abide with you. Put five on it so we can pray. So I'm going about my way. Finish my day. Is that okay?
Hallelujah.
Let's pray. Spirit of living Elohim, we love you and thank you for this opportunity to be in your presence even once again, because we absolutely love you. You are awesome. Oh, you're magnificent.
Yes.
You are forgiving Elohim. You got all power in your hand. We like the best part, and you're going to present us blameless. You are powerful. You're loving. Mm-hmm. Oh, your response to us trusting you is magnificent. Mm. All you wanted us to do is turn to you and trust you, and you would clean us up. You would present us blameless before your presence, and we're also grateful. We're in awe of your majesty and your power. We're in awe of your mercy and your kindness and your willingness to even die for us when we was yet sinners. Then you rose again with all power, willing to come back and baptize yourself inside of us to lead and guide us into all truth and present us blameless before your presence. We're ever in debt.
Yes.
We're ever so grateful. Your praises shall continually all will bless you at all times. And your praises shall continually all will bless Yahuwah at all times. And your praises shall continually be in our mouth. Hallelujah! You're worthy, 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 worthy. You're worthy. Hallelujah. 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 And amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That was the lesson, y'all.
What a
that
lesson.
Was a lesson that for the day. I pray we
yes.
all continue to obey everything
mess.
The Most High say.
Good.
Okay?
Oh,
Romans 5. We're coming back with a Romans 5 part 2 Monday morning, y'all permit. Monday morning, y'all permit. Continue.
Hallelujah.
Continue to pray.
Hallelujah.
For one another. I love y'all. Thanks for hanging out. We pray for the homeless, those who are sick in their bodies. We're praying for one another. We're definitely praying for James' mother, that the Most High have mercy and heal her. We're praying for Nola and her family, the loss of her daughter. She just had lost her son. So let's continue to pray for her. Her home going is on the 22nd this month. I plan to go over there and support that. I pray for Jasmine that the Most High continue to heal the tumor that's in her head. That the Most High have mercy and heal her heart. Hallelujah. And pray again for Leroy and pray for Mother Joyce that he continue to heal her. My mother in her eyes. I need some prayer in my body too. Continue to pray for my wife and Randall. Randall's mom and Battle's mom too, and Big Sean, he needs some prayer. His mother, Hallelujah, and my sister Felicia's husband Mike, and Mother Katie in her body, and also Katie's husband, and Joey in his body, my cousin Joey. And let's remember Mayers and her family, and pray for my nephew Gene. Pray for my nephew Gene. Roger. Pray for Roger, the Most High move in his situation. Major, pray that the Most High move in Major's situation as well. We just got a lot to pray about. Continue to pray for one another. Pray that the Most High equip His children and get us ready for what He about to do on earth. We need prayer, y'all.
We need
to stay in His faith. Y'all get prepared. Y'all get prepared spiritually first. And if you got the resources, get prepared physically for what's about to come on earth. And it's going to come soon, so get prepared now, okay?
Yes.
Most importantly, get prepared spiritually. Is that all right?
Yes.
Thanks for hanging out, too. Thank everybody who puts the share button, sharing their platforms with the truth of the word. Thank everybody that tag you, inviting folks to come on in. And thank everybody that financially support the ministry, because you should sow where you grow. You sow over there. You grow over there. You grow over there. You sow over there. But you definitely can fellowship here because we love you. We ain't number one body, but everybody should be sowing. Thank everybody that sows here. Is that all right? Y'all want to talk about it a little bit more? All you got to do is dial 302-202-1102, extension 81564, that 81568. Other than that, I love y'all. Y'all be Baruch, and Shabbat Shalom. I'm gone.